Well, hi Jamaica. I'm Kemora Reed, National Financial Controller for the National Youth Council of Jamaica. Now, as you'd have understand that our country and the world at large is going through a crisis, a pandemic, where this COVID is taking over and spreading rapidly. Now, Jamaica is one of those countries which has been trying to reduce cases and to flatten the curve. Now, as you'd have heard, the Prime Minister of Jamaica has been trying his very best to get persons to self-identify themselves who would have returned to the island starting from March 18. Now, I returned to the island on March 21st. And since returning home, I've been ensuring that I'm self-quarantined at home. Now, today is day 15. And so far, I'm feeling very fine. No symptoms. And I ensure that I self-identify myself. Now, there's only two easy ways to do so. Is to either call 888-1-LOVE. Or you can visit the site at jamcovid19.moh.gov.jm. Now, I returned on American Airlines flight 2726 into Montego Bay. And that flight was a very packed flight because there was no reserved seats possible on that flight. So I know, as the Prime Minister would have mentioned, that persons would have returned and has not yet self-identified. Now, in a time like this, you are definitely not able to pay a $1 million fine or to serve time in prison. So I'm imploring persons who would have visited or come in on this flight, and I know for sure there was about three flights that returned to the island on that day on American Airlines, to self-identify, call in so that we can assist the Ministry of Health in ensuring that they can mitigate, as also they can track these cases and to ensure that they check up on us to ensure that we are doing fine. Now, today is my first day out of self-quarantine, and I'm yet not going on the road. I'm ensuring that I spend another day to see if there's any signs, symptoms, or whatever, which would trigger me to maybe want to call in the ministry again to tell them to come and check me out. Now, let's try our very best, ladies and gentlemen, to help the Ministry of Health and the government at large to protect the Jamaican borders. Until then, let's make Jamaica a COVID-free country. One love.